Zellsis, Vibe Merchant, Mr. Montero, welcome on, bro. Good shit today, man. How you feeling?
Oh, thank you. I'm feeling good, man. Like, you know, I thought we should be in this position, you know, or at least like in playoffs, but, you know, definitely if we didn't make it right through in the group, then I definitely think we should have made play in, so expected, but I'm feeling good. I'm feeling happy that we're alive.
Before we get a bit too happy, that clutch against Mazzino, bro, you should have had that. Like, what happened, bro? You were there. You were in front of him. You couldn't get it, bro. Come on, man.
The thing was, I thought he was a lot closer than he was. Like, I had a molly. I should have just mollied the bomb, and I thought I would have won. I should have just mollied the bomb and then fought him, but I thought he was, like, a lot closer than he was. That's why I, like, kind of spammed the box. Mm-hmm. But in hindsight, yeah, I mean, I should have mollied, and I should have won it. Like, that would have been insane, but, yeah, I should have won. Fuck, man. But, you know. Yeah, you know how it is. You know how it is.
It's okay. Happens to the best of us too. We're not gonna speak about the other molly that also happened too. It's okay. There was unfortunate circumstances, but you know what? Let's just say it was all for the hype of it to make it interesting. I just want to give it to that. Speaking of the actual game, your co-stream, bro, looked like an ADHD goddamn nightmare. What are you feeding your mods to make this shit happen?
Yo, shout out my editor, bro. He does everything for me. His name's Jeho. I'm not Jeho, but he does everything for me. He does all my YouTube stuff, my editing, modding, like, he's literally just everything for me. He's not your average editor / mod. He does everything for me. So I love that man, but shout out him. You know, he makes the streams entertaining. He has like his own little identity, lets the people, that's my fan base know, kind of like his little personality. So I mess with it. You know, I love him a lot. And I appreciate him. You know, he's helping me get the bag, helping me increase the views on the watch parties. So I appreciate him a lot. Yeah.
You said once that, look, I know how much you love getting your bag up and your money up, I know, but you mentioned financial stability is not at all because you want to find the meaning of life. Have you found it yet?
No. I feel like life is a beautiful thing, man. It's very unique. It's very what you make it. You know, that's the beauty of being human. And I think, you know, I'm always trying to search for the meaning of life and, like, you know, maybe it's like right in front of me. Maybe I've already found it, you know, but sometimes you still gotta experience life. You still gotta live through it a little bit to say that you've really, you know, you're really in your bag. You know, you really like have settled down. You've really found yourself, type shit. I think I'm still looking. Okay. I think I'm still looking. But you know, that's the beauty, man. That's the beauty. It's all a game. Life's a game, bro. Life's a game.
It really is. And look, and the only thing I'm trying to play is to try to get you to play Gecko for one reason, one reason only. I talked to Cap about it, and I talked to Nathan about it. Relief. In which he specifically said that he would eat an actual dick if you played Gecko in an official. Yeah. Please make this happen, please.
I love Gecko. I think Gecko's OP, bro. I think it's OP. But, you know, sometimes, I mean, maybe in the future we'll play Gecko. Maybe we won't, can't make it. I don't know, but, you know, I think Gecko's OP. Just know that. But, yeah. I'll leave it at that.
All right. Speaking of Leaf, by the way, he says that you're the player that he misses playing with the most. Do you feel the same?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Like, that kid, I mean, bro, inside and outside the game, you know, we call him an old soul, but he's still, like, you know, a kid at heart, you know? And it's, like, it's really cute, man. It's, like, he was, like, my little brother on that team. I mean, all of them were, like, my little brother, you know? I looked at all of them, in, you know, from, like, a mentor standpoint or whatever. But I think I talked to Leaf the most, for sure, since our team broke up. So it's kind of a sweet moment between us. But, I mean, from just a player standpoint, he is, like, you know, a perfect player to me outside of, you know, his curses that he has, his top three curse or whatever that people like to say. But, I mean, I miss playing with him, man. He's really good. He's not afraid to, you know, speak his mind on things. He doesn't really get butt hurt about things when you, like, talk to him. You know, it's a real camaraderie with him. It's like, he's just like a perfect player to me in a sense, you know, and he's really talented. You know, he respects me a lot as a leader and a player. I respect him as a player. It's just a wholesome relationship, and yeah, I'd say, you know, he's one of the few people I'd like to play with again on a team, and yeah.
All right. I mean, that's beautiful. I love to hear that. But you also did say that kid, I'll respect you more once you get to 800,000 followers. Does that still hold up?
Yeah, I mean, he's got to work on his social game for sure. I always tell him to tweet. So, but I think the nice thing about him is he doesn't look at esports as like a, you know, he'll never change type thing. You know, he's always going to be like, he looks at his Twitter like a little passive thing for him to just do, like, his personality thing, have with his friends, you know, he tweets what he wants, stuff like that. And I think that's good. You know, he doesn't look at esports as like a fast cash grab or like a fame fortune type thing. It's like, you know, he's just a kid living life, finding happiness, you know. And I think that's a cool thing to do in esports. I feel like a lot of people get lost, you know, in this profession. I think a lot of people get lost with it, so it's nice to see he's, you know, never changed and probably won't change ever. So yeah,
which is definitely beautiful to speak. Speaking of social gaming, though, I think I've seen you on every single mention of saying as Zellsis by the Sand Bundle, bro. I don't know a bigger shill than you. It is wild to me, but shout out to you, man.
Get in the bag, bro. Please buy the Sand Classic Bundle. I'll appreciate it. At me on Twitter. I'll reply. I need proof, though. Dude, people are starting to just at me, and I'm going to do it because on the off chance that, like, you know, people are just baiting me for impressions, that's fine. Because if one person out of 10 baits me and they still buy the bundle, that's worth it to me.
You said today you're a Vandal player at Zephyr. Talk, you know, speak on that.
He's a Vandal player, dude. It's like, I don't know why he buys the Vandal. It's like, bro, okay, he has the aim of a Vandal player, but he has the movement of a Phantom player. That is what I always say. And like, if he could just find his Vandal movement, I mean, today he was kind of owning with the Vandal, so I'll give him that. That's why I said it. But, you know, if he could just find his little element and stick with it, yeah. I mean, he's already an Unreal player. Like, he's already dope as fuck. So if he, yeah, I mean, I love Eric. I love Zeppa. So yeah, he's a Vandal player. Okay. His little 4-1 ascent made me tweet it for context.
which is dope, bro. See, social game continues to be on point between the two of y'all, and if anything, it makes it more interesting for me as a fan of the game, just to see all this shit going on back and forth. It makes it way more interesting too. One bit back more to you as well. Look, you came into Sen like just last year, a couple months ago, with no guarantee of being a starting roster, right? You didn't play in the actual show match that they had, right? At the Invitational, came time for you to go to Korea, suddenly because visa stuff and kind of can't make it. And now you're on this team, but when joining too, there must have been a reason why you came in as sixth. Why?
It's hard, because it's like, I could give like a million reasons. It's like, honestly, I don't even know if I can pinpoint it myself, where it's kind of like, why did I choose? It's just like, I loved Sen as an organization. I loved the staff. You know, I've always thought esports, I've always taken the winning route in esports. You know, I've always tried to, like, with my decisions when I make a team or pick a team or anything like that, it's always like, okay, it's not about like the money I can make, it's not about the fame that I get, it's like about, okay, I want to win, so I'm gonna like sacrifice all of that to like try and win. And you know, to, a little information just to give out, you know, I gave up a lot of money last year to join C9. You know, I had a lot of offers around the world at the start of franchising. I had a lot of offers in NA. I've said this before, I had an offer from like every team except for 100 Thieves when franchising happened. I turned down a lot of money to join C9. And I think this year it kind of like, I was kind of stressed out the whole C9 year, you know, with like the Yay Vanity thing. Obviously, you know, budget cuts and stuff like that, like within players and teams and orgs, you know, hitting like a dry esports winter. There was a lot of pay cuts, everything, salary cuts, stuff like that. You know, we picked up two rookies. We had a really good year, but it's like, you know, it's still stressful, you know. I really came into my element as like a leader last year as well. So I'm very thankful for it. I'm very thankful. I think everything in life happens for a reason. I truly believe that. But this year, when I made my decision, it was kind of like, I'm kind of tired, you know. And obviously, I say that as I'm playing all these off-season tournaments with Zellsis that I'm now playing in the season. So, you know, fuck being tired, right? But yeah, I was kind of tired of everything. And I feel like Sentinels was kind of like a safety net where it's like, okay, even if I don't play, they still gave me a very generous offer. You know, the everything within the contract was really nice. When I was making my decision between which team I was going to join or sign with for the year or however long my contract is, whatever, you know, I talked to Rob Moore and Charlie and, you know, a lot of people at Sentinels about my decision, and they didn't try to sway me to join Sentinels. You know, they didn't try to be like, yo, like, we're gonna do this for you, we have this for you. It's like, no, it's like, okay, let's look at your offers, let's look at what people are offering you. And I was very open with them. I was very open with what I was getting offered. I was very open with, you know, all the contract stuff I was getting and everything else. And they just talked to me, you know. They're like, they had a lot of love for me from LCQ, you know. I have a lot of love for them, and they were just kind of like, you know, okay, we think this. Like, obviously, they still want me at Sen. They're like, you know, we love you at Sentinels, even if you don't choose us. It's like, there's no bad blood. We love you. Like, you know, you're always going to be wanted here, stuff like that. But after that conversation with them, it was kind of like, okay, I want to join Sentinels. You know, it's like it is the place where I need to be, even if I don't play. You know, so yeah, that kind of went on a tangent. Sorry, but I think I kind of answered the question. Yeah.
Yeah. I would say you did. And speaking of Sent as well, too, one, of course, member party organization, Tarek, prolifically known, said today while you guys are playing that on Zellsis, this guy has no idea what he's doing, but he'll try anything once. Speak to that.
Yep. Yeah. I really, you know, when I was younger in my esports career, and as just a person, I was really closed-minded. Not closed-minded, but it was like, I thought I knew, you know? I was just a dumb kid. I was like, okay, I know, you know? I feel like everyone's been there at least once in their life. But now it's like, you know, dude, you just gotta do shit, dude. It's life. You gotta, like, you know, you gotta fuck up a little bit here and there. You gotta do shit right. You gotta do shit wrong. How are you gonna learn if you don't fuck up, you know? So I'll always do something once, man. You know, even if it's the stupidest shit ever. I have this saying that we're like, I'm a little dumb on the team with all my teams. And I have this saying where it's like, I'm not trolling. I'm just dumb. I'm not trolling. I'm just dumb, you know? So, you know, you gotta do things. You gotta do things. Maybe not always by the book. You know, you gotta live a little experience.
I mean, I respect it. I'm of a very similar mentality that you haven't lived life until you've at least said yes to everything you possibly can. So I'm on the exact same wavelength. And final question for you as well, Jordan. To all your Zaddy followers, everybody out there, even the homie that was at the front that was straight up calling you Zaddy as well when asked about it, what do you got to say to them and all the Sand fans out there who've been out here riding for you, waiting for y'all to come back here?
Oh, man. I love, as much as I hate the Sand fans, I love them too, man. Y'all are ruthless, bro. I'm not going to lie. I respect it. Sentinels fans are like sports fans, dude. They live or die by Sentinels, and I love that, whether it comes with the good or the bad. But to all my fans, to all the Sentinels fans, all the Zaddies, the mommies, I love all of you guys. Thank you guys for supporting me. Thank you guys for supporting my team. Thank you guys for supporting esports. It allows me to do what I can do. And I'm going to keep being me. And to all the haters, screw you.
Valid as fuck. All right.
Valid. Valid.
That's the light to hear. Zellsis, thank you. This was a pleasure and a lot of fun. We'll catch you tomorrow, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Take care.